Hey, what's up YouTube? My name is Dewan. I want to thank you for tuning into my channel. Now, I started out my career, I started with Packet Tracer. And so today this video is to help you download the latest and greatest version of Packet Tracer 7. Now what we're going to do is pull up Google and do a quick Google search. You can use Firefox or whatever else you use, but I use Google. And so we're going to do a Google search for download Packet Tracer Pipe Cisco Netacad. And I'll put a link in the description below. Now what Netacad is, it's a curriculum set up by Cisco, provided to universities and different training organizations to help people achieve their CCNA. What we're going to do is scroll down to the version that we're going to download. We're going to select Packet Tracer for Windows or Linux. I'm using Windows 10, so we're going to sign up for English. You can also log in if you have an account. But if you don't, we're going to select English because I speak English. I don't speak French. All right, this is going to take you to a sign-up page. And on the sign-up page, you'll put in your first name. We're going to do blah, blah for the last name. And then we're going for the email, we'll do blah at blah dot blah. And now you'll have to do the text verification. Turn on my numlock. All right. And then hit enroll. What this will do is take you to a verification page to let you know that, hey, we just sent you a verification email. We need you to activate your Cisco Netacad account. I already have a Netacad account. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to log in and catch you guys here in a moment. Okay. Once you go through that verification email, you'll have to create an account with the username and password, set up all your first name, last name, and all that good stuff. Once that's created, you'll be in the My Netacad page. One of the first things you'll see is the courses that you are currently enrolled in. And one of those courses, well, probably the only course, will be Packet Tracer 101. And what this is a one-hour tutorial put together by Cisco to break down the new things within Packet Tracer version 7. And it's pretty in-depth. I've been using Packet Tracer since version 4, and 7 has a lot of things. It has a lot of Internet of Things going on. It's pretty cool. But what we'll do is scroll down to resources and click Packet Tracer. Now, this will take you to a download page. On this download page, you select the version of Packet Tracer that you desire for your current operating system. Now, I'm using Windows 10 64-bit. So I'm going to select that. Now, they also have mobile versions that you can try on like your iPhone. I had it. It's okay. So we'll click download 64-bit, and I'll catch you guys in a moment. Okay, now that the download is complete, you can either click on this executable, or you can open up your Explorer and go to downloads and double-click the executable. We'll do that. It's going to ask, do you really want to install this UAC? Yes, I do. Okay, so now we'll next. I accept. Is this the pass you want to store it to install? Yes, I do. Yes. Would you like a desktop icon? Now, I don't really like them, but if you like them, go ahead and do it. We'll do it for this purpose. Click next and install. But once this is done, we'll pull up Packet Tracer. I'll show you guys a few things, and then that's it. You guys will be off and rocking to your CCNA. Okay. Yes, we know. Skills base. Please restart your computer. Now, would you like to launch Packet Tracer? Yes, we would like to. Now, since this is a Netacad version, which is a student version, we'll click OK. Packet Tracer will open, and it will have us log into Netacad. Okay, so the first time Packet Tracer opens, it opens with this Netacad login to say, hey, I need an authorized certificate for Packet Tracer. But if you kind of minimize it and look down, you can log in with a guest account. I recommend just logging in the first time with your Netacad account. Okay, you can set that up through the firewall however you like. And what I usually do is I just tell it whatever. Then I go back in my firewall settings and I just tell it, no, you can't talk to the internet. Because really, there's no reason for a packet tracer to go outside of my computer. Okay. Just quick rundown. Now, this is a pretty in-depth version of packet tracer compared to the previous versions. Now, I use GNS3. I have a lot of hardware, and I love hardware, hands down. GNS3 is very in-depth, but to get your CCNA, when I took my test, which was last year, packet tracer was enough. But this version, oh man, there's so many things you can do. And I just can't wait to play around with it. I'm definitely going to build labs and do some of this Internet of Things. You know, I guess there's a lot of PoE devices that can power these different, it looks fun. But one of the things I wanted to show you is, so here are your network devices. These are going to be your routers and then your switches, the 2960, 2950, you know, the standards. And they have a 3560, which is the layer 3 switch. So you can do switching and routing on that. And they also have your end devices, which is going to be your desktops, your laptops, your servers, your VoIP phones, and all that good stuff. Then you got your cables. Everything looks pretty much traditional. So we'll connect this PC through fast Ethernet 0 to this switch, fast Ethernet 01. Let's keep that. Let's get rid of this layer 3 switch. We don't need that. And we're just going to set up a quick small business network up real fast. All right, so we have a PC connected to a switch, connected to a router. Boom, boom. And there you go. You can configure these however you like. One of the things I do is I go in here in prefaces and I adjust my font to a larger font. I adjust that because I just don't like the smaller fonts. And I also don't like the standard background. But the only hiccup I've seen on this version is, for some reason, when I go in here to change the background, it doesn't change to black. You can only do a white background, which is weird. You can do any color font you want. You just have to keep the background, even if you change it to whatever else on, it stays the same. I don't know why. Hopefully they fix that. I don't know. Yeah, everything stays the same. So, in conclusion, we created a Cisco Netacad account. We downloaded Packet Tracer 7 and installed Packet Tracer 7. And we created a small network just for demonstration purposes in Packet Tracer. I hope you like this video. Please feel free to subscribe and share it with your friends. And also like this video. And if you have any comments, please leave it in the section below. I thank you for viewing.